Check this out. He said in verse 6, when he saw Jesus, I want you to know this man was wild. This man was full of rage. This man was living in a tomb. This man was in bondage. This man couldn't be helped out. This man was just, I mean, he was the worst that you could be, living in a graveyard. And this is what happened. When he saw Jesus from a distance, he ran and fell on his knees in front of him. And he shouted at the top of his voice, "What do you want with me, Jesus, Son of the Most High God?" And then he said, he knew authority when he saw it. And you know you've heard about the Bible. You know you've heard about Jesus. Now maybe somebody hurt you. Maybe somebody stung you. Maybe some deacon treated you wrong. Maybe some usher treated you wrong. Maybe some pastor did you wrong. Maybe somebody hurt your family. But I'm here to beg forgiveness for each one of them, tell you, be mad at them, but don't be mad at God. Get God, let God be in your corner. Listen to me. And then right after you get back home with God, I want you to forgive them. Because they know not what they do. That's it. God Paul said, if you hurt one of these my little ones, it is better than you tie a millstone around your neck and cast yourself in the deepest part of the earth. God doesn't want our young people on drugs. God doesn't want our young people on earth. God doesn't want our young people getting along. God wants our young people to be in college, in school, all in the peace of America like they should be. I was here for the house down here, but they need to be owning something for themselves. Not living in prison, not being hungry, not stealing stuff, but they should be living right, man. We earn that right to live here in America. Am I right or wrong? Make some noise, come on. Let me take you a little further here. He said, swear to God that you won't torture me. These demons are in him now. And listen, a lot of people say, I cast the demon out of that chair. I cast the demon out of the car. I mean, a demon made me lose my key. You know what? Ain't no demon make you lose your key. I knew some knucklehead one time that ate 12 Dunkin' Donuts. Next thing I know, he's praying. In the spirit, I'm like, come on, Dunkin' Donuts. And he's throwing up all over the place. I said, if you think that's a demon, I think it's a dummy. The dummy that ate the Dunkin' Donuts, you don't shove 12 donuts down your throat and expect to be happy. You know, it's going to come out somewhere. Come on now, this is straight preaching. It's going to come out somewhere. And this guy's going, come out, I rebuke you, come out. Listen, he should have been standing in front of me and said, I rebuke you, come out. The one that demon up is a dummy. You following me? Well, that joke went over like a lead balloon. He said, beg you won't torture me. Why? Because a demon needs something warm and hot to run into, something alive, living. You follow me? So this is what he said. He says, for Jesus had said to him, come out of this man, you evil spirit. That's why the man said, don't hurt me, don't torture me. Don't send me out into oblivion. And watch what happened. Then Jesus asked him, what is your name? And he said, my name is Legion, for we... He replied, for we are many. Folks, sometimes we think our problem is our rent. Sometimes we think our problem is my coke addiction. Sometimes we think our problem is my neighbor. Sometimes we think our problem is I ain't ever got a good break. Sometimes we think our problem is the welfare, is the WIC department, is the health department. Sometimes we think our problem is that person that raped me, that person that touched me. Sometimes we blame it on everybody. Except to say, you know what? Sometimes I'm even part of the problem. And it's time for me to ask God to forgive me and build the bridge and get over this. Listen, your past is your past. Amen. What I did, I did. It's in concrete. I can't change that. Anybody change concrete? You can't, it's done. It's been fixed in time. But I'll tell you what I can do. I can change my future to glorify God. I can change my future to lift up the name of Jesus. Stay with me. My name is Legion, for we are many. Sometimes there's many things that are holding you down. Many things that are entrapping you. Many things that are making you feel like you're unqualified, uncertified, unworthy, like you're down. My color, my race, my language, my speech, my education, my money, all these things. But I come to tell you that God says, I use the foolish things of this world to confound the wise. I choose the things that are not, to choose the things that are. He said, I came to lift you up. He said, if you'll lower yourself, humble yourself. He said, I will lift you up and place your feet upon a rock that cannot be moved. Are you ready? don't know if you read it. A large herd of pigs was feeding on a nearby hillside. And the demons begged Jesus, send us among the pigs. Allow us to go into them. They just wanted to hang out. You know, sometimes that's what we do with our issues. We let them hang out in another room. Come on now, right? I ain't doing crack no more. I'm just an alcoholic now. Or I stop doing cocaine. I'll shoot heroin now. I'll stop all that stuff. I ain't doing none of that stuff. Only internet porno. Come on now. Oh, the baby get a bum, fool Jesus, you don't get none. I like internet preaching. A large herd of pigs feeding on a nearby hillside. The demons begged Jesus, Jesus, send us among the pigs and allow us to go into them. He gave them permission. He gave them permission. He is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. The devil is not equal in power to Jesus. Somebody say you believe that right now. Greater is Jesus. The devil, listen, Jesus can't sin. Jesus is the Lord of all. Jesus is the Lord of everything. Watch this. He gave them permission and the evil spirits came out and went into the pigs. The herd, about 2,000 in number, rushed down a steep bank and into the lake and were drowned. You see, Jesus had them have their way like Burger King had it your way. They were going to die anyway. You with me? Now watch this. Those tended. This is why I want y'all people in the church to listen up. And those of you that have been hurt to listen up. Those of you that have been in church to listen up. It says this. Those tending the pigs ran off and reported this in the town and countryside. What did they report? And the people went out to see what happened. When they came to Jesus, they saw the man who had been possessed by a legion of demons sitting there. He was dressed and in his right mind. Anybody follow me? And they were afraid. Why would it make you afraid that I got on drugs? Why would I be afraid if you went to college, man? Why would I be afraid if you started owning your own home? Why would I be afraid if you got free from any addiction or something? Why would I be afraid? Why would I be afraid of a church that's preaching the gospel? Why would I be afraid of a church that says that we're going to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ and we're not new? Why would I be afraid? Because it's bad for business. You see, it's not bad for God's business. It's bad for the business of the world. Because when people say this is our corner, when people say we're going to love anybody that walks in the door, whosoever shall grace these doors is going to feel the love of God. When it hurts us, when we say that, we be listening. We become bad for business. That means that drug addicts got to shut down. They can't be out here unless people start singing, bringing in the sheep, and feeding pit bulls hot dogs. Because that's what we're going to do. Why? You begin to be bad for business, and they'll want to get rid of you. We ain't going nowhere. We're going to love you until you get in this house. And if you don't come to us, we're going to go to you and find where you are. You ready? Those tending pigs ran off. Verse 15. When they came to Jesus, they saw the man that had been possessed by a legion of demons sitting there dressed and in his right mind. Sitting there? Sitting. A man that was cutting himself, sitting. A man that was naked, running around like a nut, dressed. A man that was crazy in his right mind. Isn't that a beautiful thing to see? Somebody listen, clean 26 years. Is just as strong as being clean for a day and a half. Amen. I don't know about you, but everybody knows somebody in their family that's screwed up. Everybody knows somebody in their family that's more toasted than a box of cornflakes. And we need to get them to the Lord and get them in the right mind. Right or wrong, man, we need to get them to God and get them in the right mind. Que también para Señor. Check this out. Those who had seen it told the people what had happened to the demon-possessed man and told about the pigs as well. Hey, y'all know that guy that was a nut that everybody's kids was afraid of when we were scared to let our kids out? Well, that happened, and that guy's in his right mind. But the pig business screwed up too because they all drowned. Watch what happened. Deep story. Because this is what the world thinks of you. And that's why we're here to stay. You stand with me? Come on now. And they told about the pictures of God. Then the people began to plead with Jesus, leave the region. Jesus, please get out of here. Jesus, please get out of here. Sinless, please get out of here. You're bad for business, man. I've been dealing my dope on the corner. I've been dealing my crack on the corner. My kids are bringing in money. Please leave, Jesus. We found some guns. We're selling stuff. All this stuff. And you're bad for business. Listen to me. You got our pig business, our hog business, our swine business. Now think about that. Swine. Pig business. And you messed our pig business up. Could you please get out of here, Jesus? Can you believe that people, because of money, would not want Jesus? Can you believe that people that were scared of a man, that was a nut, that was crazy, that was unpressed, that was scared, that would cut himself, that could not be held down, that was in bondage, and when he was free, they would say, we'd rather have the bound man, we'd rather have the junkie, rather have the crackhead, than to have a free place, because it's bad for the worldly business. Watch this, you ready? Then the people began to plead with Jesus. Come on, leave, man. Get out of here, Jesus. Come on, man. You're screwing up our pork business, man. Pork chops are under the sea now. Under the sea. Under the things are up there. I'm sorry. Got into like a whole SpongeBob SquarePants routine. That's another sermon. The mermaid. Sorry, I was corrected. Thank God I didn't know exactly what that movie was. As Jesus was getting into the boat, listen to this. As Jesus was getting into the boat, the man who had been demon-possessed begged to go with him. Man, isn't that something? You know, I know God that did that. You see, I didn't want to see no more black people, no more Puerto Rican people, and no more white people from the ghetto ever again. I don't want you to take offense, man. I was wrong. See, I was in the pig business. I was in the Take Care Jimmy business. I've been shot, and I've been stabbed, I've been cut open, man. I've taken drugs, stuck them in my arm, to save from, I don't know, man. I don't know why I don't have no hepatitis, AIDS, or something else, or, you know, everything, man. I should have syphilis and everything, man. Just, I don't know, man. But God found me and put me in my right mind. I'm going to show you something, man. And I want you to take this on. I want you to hear from a preacher straight up, because a lot of preachers won't talk you straight. But when I got clean, I said, I never want to be in another ghetto again. Because that's how we are when we get a little bit of vengeance, right? Moving on up and be like a Jefferson and get out of his Dodge, right? I'm going to write it on. Or be like a Chico and the man. I don't care. I've got my Ravens too. But the bottom line is that we want to get out. Yeah. Am I right or wrong? We want to get out, man. I did my time myself, and I got some benefits. I got a settlement or something. And let me get out of here. And I tried that, man. I tried to go someplace else and preach and teach and be a pastor. And you know, God made me uncomfortable. God shook my world up, and God said, "You know where I called you to be. You know where I called you to be. You know where I called you to do. And I want you to get back to where you're supposed to be." And God, listen. I gotta tell you, it's not about money, it's about loving people. It's not about programs, it's about people. It's not about anything else, it's about loving the people of God. It's about feeding hungry people. It's about seeing babies smile. It's about doing something nice for somebody. Man, it's about taking somebody to go get gas. Something kind and nice, man. And I tell you something, man, I'm the happiest man on the planet. I'm gonna leave you in the box and put a fork in my hand and say, "You're going for dessert now with Jesus." That's it, man. Let me lock it up for you. So the man wanted to go with Jesus. "Lord, let me go with you. I'm clean now. They all think I'm a bum. They never." How many of you change and people won't let you change? Come on now, be honest. Put your hands up. Come on. How many of you try to change and people just ain't buying? "Oh, I know that. I know that look. Oh, I know where you've been. Where you been at? You know what I mean? I need a quarter to take a walk so I can call you up and let you know, 'Hi, I'm two blocks away now. Hi, I'm three blocks away now.
I'm 4.5 blocks away now. Here, I look out the door, wait, see, that's me. Thank you. You know what I mean? What a lack of trust, man. We got to start loving each other again, forgiving each other again. We cannot live under this bondage. Listen, life is not a dress rehearsal. You get one shot at it, and you got to start enjoying it. Say, I will not live in fear. I will not live in fear, because God has not given me a spirit of intimidation, a spirit of fear, but a spirit of power, love, and a sound mind. And God, He don't care. Listen, I dropped out of the eighth grade, and I know God set my mind right. He put a brain in my head, got them things that they said would never work right. He turned me around and put me and said, I want you to speak. I was a man that stuttered all my life, and God saved me for a reason. And I love to preach the word of God. I love to praise God. I'm almost done. Jesus, in verse 19, did not let him go. He said, go home. He said, go home. Go home to your family, man, and tell them how much the Lord has done for you and how He had mercy on you. You see, sometimes we try that great escape. I got mine, man. I got free. Let me get on that lady. But God said, Don't get this, brother. You ain't going to the other side. You're going back, man. I want you to tell them how much I love them. And that's going to be your call. And you're going to be happy in it. You're going to be happy in it. It's not a strain, man. Listen, me, preaching this tonight was like, it's a joy. This is like too easy. I don't even have notes because it's too easy.